here we go, Blunt Ambition, Nice, you better not have built this up too much. You better not have built this up too much because I'm so excited. Let's go. Goes without saying, I don't know the set list. I've got no idea what's coming up. Is this like the Metropolis thing? So we've got Express Yourself to start. Okay. I mean, is this like a Nine Inch Nails show or Madonna? What's going on? I just wanna know one thing. Ask it to quote a lot more. Cause I got something to say about it. And it goes something like this. Don't come for second best, baby. Put your love to the test. You know you got to make him express how it feels. And maybe then you know your love is real. Expect yourself. You've got to make him expect yourself. Hey, hey, hey. I can't believe how good this is. Yeah, Nicki and Dolla are brilliant, obviously. Obviously great. Gorgeous. It's so dramatic, the level of artistry on display there. It's so simple, but... who else could do it? Such a complicated routine. The clothes she's wearing are great. Jean-Paul Gaultier designed all the outfits, didn't he? So this is just everything top drawer, highest level it could possibly be. Let's keep going. That's a live vocal. I forgot how great this song was. It's so good. Oh my god, what is this shit? I love how chaotic this is. Great. Get over here, both of you. I want to kick your asses. Stop fucking with me. You get the picture? Alright. I'm the fucking boss around here, okay? I don't know why, I didn't think she'd swear. Yeah, fuck. Okay. Whoa. Back again. Seeing that again. That looks hard to do, maybe it's dead simple. You've got Nicki and Donna doing that crazy dance routine with Madonna. And then all that swearing and all that, like, this is my fucking show, I'm the fucking whatever. I don't know why that surprised me so much. Michael Jackson wouldn't say fuck. Bon Jovi wouldn't say fuck. Who else was big in 1990? I mean, it's more the kind of thing you'd hear at like a Guns N' Roses show or something like that. It's delightfully unhinged, but there's this like element of chaos to it, which is Madonna at the centre of it, and I've no idea what she's going to do next. Wow. With a gun to my head and $1 million, I wouldn't have guessed this song. Great. Wow. Okay. Oh my god.
Unbelievable.
God?
Fucking hell. Okay. Holy shit. Like a virgin, like a prayer. I mean, talk about the two sides, the whore and the Madonna thing. Bloody hell. It's perfect. It's perfect. I love thinking about how many Catholic countries she'll have performed this in. Italy, Spain, France is probably pretty Catholic. Joan of Arc as well. Yeah, okay. I'll talk later. She's in confession. This is so clever. Unbelievable vocal, such a good vocal, and her intensity, her stagecraft. Oh my goodness. Okay. Oh. This sounds amazing, that bass line. Wow. My friend, I mean, those guys look cool as shit. They look so good. Wow. Wow. Beautiful. Beautiful. I'm not joking when I say that's probably the best 20 minutes of music I've ever heard. It's certainly the best live performance I've ever seen in my entire life. There's no two ways about that. First of all, I was thinking, wow, Like a Virgin, that's a great version with those Eastern strings. They sounded incredible. It ends with her like writhing about on the bed, masturbating, simulating sex. I mean, basically things that would have been shocking to most audiences anywhere, let alone the world's biggest pop star on stage. And then Like a Prayer started and I started crying pretty much instantly. And that was because it was so good. Like, I was literally thinking, like, wow, this is like a superhuman person doing this. And I was just thinking, like, this is the best thing I've ever seen. Then we go into Live to Tell, was it? And that's just a gut punch anyway. And that goes into Oh Father. Now, that almost finished me off because by this point, this is getting to be on an emotional level. It's not just like, it's amazing. So at this point, watching the Madonna performance, you know, we've got, she's at confession, we've got fatherhood themes, we've got Catholicism, forgiveness, it's a lot. I don't always overshare like this, but you know, for you to understand the emotions and the feelings that I'm having when I'm, you know, listening to and watching this stuff is the least I can do. I appreciate you being here with me. I share back with you. This is where we go. Let's have something a bit lighter now, maybe. Love this vocal, love this live vocal. Treat me like I'm a bad girl, even when I'm pretty good to girl. I don't want you to thank me, you can just spank me.
Dick, you got a lot of nerve. You know what? You got a lot of dick.
That Dick Tracy stuff is so fun. That Sooner or Later performance was really, really good. Like, proper good singing. Great staging of that one. Not as good as the Oscars version, obviously, but, like, in its own way, really, really impressive. Okay. She's doing that voice. Hey, first shot of the drummer, Sugarfoot. Okay. Amazing. Oh, wow. I love this song so much.
Are you blind? Will you play with me?
Oh, awesome. Oh, my God. Lovely. That is great. Oh. This is so much better than Material Girl. I love this song. It's one of her sweetest pop songs. Gorgeous. I love it. Love this performance. She's kind of recreating that video, but on a very low budget. And getting on with the mermaids. The mermen.
And God said to Eve, oh no, now the fish are gonna smell like it.
I knew you'd enjoy that one. That's why I said it. Oh, yourself. It was funny. Boots.
I'm slowly getting that joke. That's funny.
How often do you know these guys?
They're fat.
Hey, you guys, truth or dare? Truth or dare?
Truth or dare?
You want to fuck us?
Okay. Well, you know, you really never get to know a guy until you ask him to wear a rubber.
Oh, yeah.
No.
But you gotta do it.
Boots.
But you gotta do it.
Hey, you, don't be silly. Put a rubber on your willy.
Awesome. Awesome.
Ew.
That's great.
Oh.
Awesome. 1990. Very good. And Nikki and Donna are just transformative to her live show, aren't they? Their backing vocals are essential for this. Oh yeah. Let's have an extended version of this. All good. I love the extra stuff he's adding to this. His ad-libs and stuff. Perfect. Wow. Ah! Oh. Okay. Alright, sit back. That bass line. Oh, this is going to be amazing. I like how seamlessly Nikki and Donna blend into the guys as well. That poise, that style, that elegance, it's just all there. To recreate live as well, this seems like more of a studio song, but works great. Here we go. Oh yeah. Oh wow. Amazing. Especially seeing that live. I mean, tell me if you were there. Tell me your thoughts on this. But to me, best song of the night so far as a single thing. Obviously, my favourite bit is going to be that religion section. But as a one-off section, that was like a bomb going off on stage. Stunning. Stunning. Ian Donna, man. Their backing vocals are so good. Like, they're slightly rough in their own way. Not that they're out of tune. But like, they're so full of life and energy. They're not like studio perfect, are they? Which is what you want. You want this to be like, life, full of life. Real. Was that in this tour you were saying like she mixes a certain song with Family Affair or something? That's the only thing I can think of that you've told me about that I haven't seen yet. Anyone got that? Anyone got that tour program signed? Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah. Well, there we go then. There we go.
Blood thicker than mud. Here's a family affair. Keep it together.
That was it. Okay. Oh, it's so good. Oh, it's so good. Oh my God. That's great. That's great. What a good idea. Literally relying on her family there to just help her get forward, isn't she? It's clever. That's clever. Whoa. Oh my god. Alright, where do you start? I mean, that was just mind-blowing. The amount of skill and vision and talent to get that on stage is just unbelievable. I can't wait to watch that documentary to kind of see what went on behind the scenes. So that Truth or Dare, I'll do that next month. The level of skill, just in one of the talents that she has, like songwriting, like having those ideas, like singing, dancing, the musicality of it, it's just amazing that one person, one woman, can have all this stuff inside her. You've got like cutting edge dance, pop, rock, funk. You've got an amazing live band. I keep mentioning Jonathan Sugarfoot Moffat, but really he is absolutely stunning. Like I've said before, his videos that he films now for Drumeo, where he does Michael Jackson songs, get like millions of views. And as far as I know, he hasn't done Madonna. And that's probably because I haven't asked him. And that's probably because Madonna doesn't get the respect that she deserves. I think the stuff he's doing with her is just as impressive. And I wonder if she doesn't get her due because, first of all, she's a woman, but secondly, she's funny. She's kind of ramshackle, she's wacky, and it makes it seem like something you shouldn't take seriously, which is kind of true on one level, like you shouldn't take anything seriously, it's life, you know, it's crazy, fuck it. But just because someone's got a sense of humour and it's pop and it's sung by a woman, doesn't mean there isn't an insane amount of skill and practice and talent and, you know, just everything involved. You know this anyway. And as just a fan of music, live music, singing, songwriting, pop music, rock music, Madonna's importance, her contribution is not to be underestimated, you know? She is obviously one of the best ever to do it. But for now, I will say thank you so much for watching. Thank you for all your comments. Thanks for contributing. Please keep coming back because I'm not going to stop. See you soon. Bye.